It's a roller coaster of emotions when you go from stressful RV parking to fun adventures with friends, only to end up at the wrong place at the wrong time.
Well, we just got a tsunami warning, 11 o'clock at night. This is terrifying. I mean, do we follow everybody else? But the problem is if you go towards Kenai, you're just following the coast, like you're following the water.
Alaska, well known for its vast wildlife, endless outdoor adventures, and world-class fishing. Oh yeah, might we add, plenty of rainy, cool days during the summer season. After exploring the breathtaking beauty of Valdez and Palmer, it was time to conquer the legendary Kenai Peninsula, Hank style. This story begins at Diamond M Ranch RV Resort in Kenai, Alaska. You know what is so wonderful about travel days? We get to go somewhere new. And I love that. Off to Homer, Alaska we go. I've heard a lot of great things about this area where we're going. And per Google, it is the halibut fishing capital of the world. You know, every place has that thing that they're known for. We're posting up in Anchor Point at a small RV park there, and then we'll be about a 20-minute drive to Homer, which I think is pretty good. So if you guys are looking for RV parks to stay when you go somewhere touristy, don't forget that you can go on the outskirts of that area. You could save some money by doing that. I do see some fishing in our near future. We've been talking about wanting to go fishing, but it's a little bit more complicated than just going fishing. You have to go with people who are experienced. You have to have all the gear, and the issue with going with some of these companies is that they're very expensive. Very expensive. I'm not saying you don't get your money's worth. I'm not saying that at all, but it's like sometimes $400 a person, and if you have a large family and you're on a budget, that can be really difficult. We're on a budget as well because everything in Alaska is pricey, and don't you worry, we are going to be breaking down the costs of like how the Alaska trip was, like RV parks, everything. We track every penny still to this day because that is what helped us become debt free, was like watching where our money goes. And because of that wonderful habit, it has stuck with us and we still do it to this day.
And look, we're here.
What do we got here? What is here for us?
Anchor Point. What kind of turn is this? Look at this thing. Like, what does that even mean? Yep, we're good. Hey, at least the weather's cooperating with us. It's gonna be nice and rainy when we go to unhook.
Groceries. I mean, it's nothing major, but it's groceries. Oh, we're going down a hill. Wow. Never been here before.
Really? First time for me too. You wanna hang out?
I'm Renee.
Nice to meet you. Carl.
I do like that there's a lot of walking trails in this area. Hopefully bears. I want to see bears. I don't want to get close to a bear, but I would like to see one at a distance, you know? This is small. I told you it was going to be small.
Oh, wow.
I don't even know if we both fit in here at the same time. Holy cow, where are we even going to go? There's no turning around.
No.
Oh my gosh.
I'll just go this way. We're just going this
way. We're
going
this way.
I don't even know. Look, we're already at the end of the park.
Ah! We're here.
Yep, this is it, honey.
Okay.
We're actually on our side already, so hop on out. I'll show you the amenities.
Okay, thanks.
Water, sewer, electric, ever heard of it? You have? I'll show you anyways. Isn't that how they always do it at the RV park? We're home, Stinky.
Was that Dad? Did Dad call you Stinky?
Ah.
Tell everybody you get bored. Your belly's full, but you get bored. Anyone else who has a Siamese cat understands.
Okay, I talked to the lady.
Okay.
And she said we're going into 9 and 10.
Oh, sweet.
She's like, I was trying to stop you. I missed you. I was like, no problem. We're already in the position. Back up and get right in our sight.
All
right. That's what we're going to do. Put it in R for race and go backwards.
Okay. Yeah. Wow, everybody's getting the behind the scenes. Wow.
Who's everyone? Oh, snap. I didn't know you guys were here. Welcome. Welcome to chaos.
Yeah, look at how we're procrastinating on backing
in. Yeah, we're just going to sit here for a couple hours and be like, it's raining.
Where's the valet? Park your RV service. I'm so cold.
What a nut. That woman is something else. And that's why I married you. Look at her. She looks like she's off the movie Coneheads back in the day. Remember that one with Dan Aykroyd? You want me to just back up? Start backing up?
You can start backing up. Let's try our Apple Watches together.
Apple Watches?
Then I'll use the phone to get some awesome shots for you guys. But just know I'm cold and out here in the rain, so.
Send some warm love.
Hello?
Okay, perfect.
Bye. Go up to Keith and ask him if he's ever backed in an RV before, because goodness, it's been 10 minutes.
You know, this would be a perfect time to do it.
Nice day out. Yeah. What's going on over there?
They're small sites, for sure. I mean, it said it would accommodate their length, but since they got that mini split, they're like a tiny bit longer now.
Well, that's okay, because the best part is we're in no rush. Normally, rainy days and backed up travel plans would stress us out, but not anymore. We're in control. Kinda.
What is that? What is that? Where did that come from?
No.
Howdy. Let's do this.
Mom back.
Swing it a little bit more here.
Okay, you're cut maybe too much now. Start cutting it hard. Like as much as you can.
Just don't look at those rocks there.
Oh my God, there's moose right there.
There's like two huge moose.
They were right behind me. Did you see that? I thought it was a person behind me and I jumped and...
There was moose right there the whole time.
Oh my God, there's so much going on. I thought you were gonna run into me because I was standing like right behind you. Like, you know what? Just keep pushing it like that because that'll work, I think. Yeah, keep doing that, keep doing that. I'm just watching my six for more moose. If you do that and then like you just will pull forward and just have to wiggle it in here. Look, and I'm so nervous that more moose are gonna be behind me. That was wild. This ain't Alaska all in one shot here.
Raining moose and hard backins. Just don't get better than this.
Okay, that's too tight, too much. Yeah, come back, go ahead. Cause we're gonna try to split this thing and.
Okay, you just said pull forward. Now you went back. See what you're gonna deal with.
Perfect, keep coming back like that. Okay, stop. You're hitting the tree. Sorry, you're hitting the tree.
That might be good.
Yeah, pull forward a little bit though, because you're really into the tree here. Wow, whoopsie. Okay, right there is probably good. Oh wait, hold on, this thing. I know. Okay, stop, that's perfect.
It's wet inside the truck right now. It is raining right here. I just want to let you know in on that secret. I don't know about you, but I'm freezing my butt off in here.
I'm looking for the moose.
She's gonna kill me.
One here in the Hanks household. 5 o'clock. It always comes a little bit too early. I kind of feel like I'm talking to you guys a lot with my eyes closed right now, for good reason. Who knows what's going on behind these eyelids? You don't want to know. Fishing today. Yes, finally. Alaska, we're doing it the right way this time. All y'all halibut fish out there, look out. We're coming for you. Starting to wake up now. I got my favorite tea on, so that's bringing good vibes. I will let her rip when we get out on the boat too. Let her rip in the fact that I'm gonna rip some fish out of that ocean and feed our family. Wilderness Carl's coming out. By the way, I'm hitting this stuff hard today, okay? No seasickness today. Sea legs? Yeah, I'm all about that. Seasickness? No. You could take the back seat. All right, Hank's family, we gotta roll out. We got 10 minutes to get there. We gotta walk and go. Let's go.
All right. Wait, we gotta pack some sodies.
Here we go with hooking up the whole camper. See, when you go on excursion with Nay, she tends to take everything with her. like everything you could possibly imagine that you might need in a case of an emergency, which is great, but then I only have one backpack and she overloads it to like 50 pounds. So the inside joke is that I'll just go hook up the camper and take everything with us. Maybe they'll just tow the camper behind the boat today. That might work.
Listen, when you're starving in a few hours, you're gonna thank me.
Listen, I'm not eating, okay? I'm gonna keep my belly empty. I'm NPO, which is a fancy nursing term for not eating. And yeah, nothing by mouth.
Oh, good morning, by the way.
Just a typical day in the Hanks household. Oh, by the way, I got your muck boots on. Those things that you've been carrying since we sold our house back in 2017, you never wear them.
Yes, my muck boots. I'm so glad we have them.
Me too. Wonder if we're gonna encounter any moose along our walk here. And I forgot to tell you guys the other morning, I got some sweet shots of moose as well, and some eagles. And okay, there was this one bird. I gotta know your guys' opinion. What is this bird? It is driving me bananas. Is it an eagle? I think it is. It's of the eagle family. But give me some specifics here, everyone, because I need all the help we can get. But how about the Hanks finally getting some sightings of some wildlife? That's what I'm talking about.
We got the fish.
Our freezer is gonna be an overload.
But now, what do? Because we live in an RV and our freezer is like this big.
I feel like Santa Claus.
You got that?
You know, I'm managing.
A short drive from Anchor Point landed ourselves in the famous Homer Spit. Hey, we needed a break from all that halibut, so we decided to explore other flavors of Alaska. With plenty of parking, food, and shops to explore, we were fully immersed. But to our surprise, our adventure in the beautiful Kenai Peninsula felt like it had come to an end all too soon.
Well, we just got a tsunami warning. 11 o'clock at night, we're like in Homer area. I don't know if that's like considered higher ground. Do you have a topography map to see that, or?
I just know that bluff is right there. You know, when you look across the way and there's those houses.
Yeah.
And then we're up on that same elevation.
If there's a back road that takes us to like a mountain too, that'd be ideal.
I would decide to the highest elevation.
This is terrifying. I mean, do we follow everybody else? But the problem is if you go towards Kenai, you're just following the coast. Like, you're following the water.
Right.
How much fuel do we have, too, is another concern. Here, let's get our radios on. Hey, we have our radio on. Let's charge up our phones while we can.
Trying to get as much light as I can here. Sorry, I know the video quality is horrible. But we are in the middle of parking lot. Keith right now is talking to the state police here, trying to get an idea where we should head. All we knew to do at the time was grab Dexter, grab a couple of our quickest valuables within reach, put on our shoes, and head out the door. And that's exactly what we did. We don't know what's to come. But if you're ever in this situation, just get out. Don't
start panicking and trying to grab everything, just make sure you're safe. That's the most important thing. Stay calm. What up, my man?
Okay, so she said the warning and the soon there was a, like a 7-point something earthquake that happened over by like Kodiak, and I guess that's where the tsunami warning is. So they're not even evacuating Homer along the spit right now. So she said if it is danger for here specifically, we would get another warning and then they would be driving on the roads like with sirens and stuff like that.
Okay.
So I'm freezing.
I'm cold too.
I was not prepared for this.
Might be the adrenaline, man.
Yeah, so I think we're actually good to go back.
Okay.
And then she said we'd get another warning.
Okay. So, wait, did you find out where to go if we do get another warning?
Here.
Just right here?
Yeah, she said this is high enough.
Well, I guess that's the best possible news we can get. Stinky Butt is safe. And he's not sure what's going on, but hey, you do what you can.
Yeah, and I didn't grab his cage because my thought is, like, if we're dealing with water, like, the last thing I want him in is a cage.
Yeah.
If you guys want to come back, if you're comfortable, I think you're completely fine. We're not going anywhere. Right now, the waves in Sandpoint are only 1.5 feet.
Okay.
And the Cook Inlet that we're on is super shallow.
Okay.
And there are buoys all the way, so they measure them, and they give us times. Like, it wouldn't even touch Kodiak until, like, 12:35, I think. You have plenty of time, and I don't think we're going to see anything, but we will continue to watch. So if you guys want to come back, I think you're safe.
Oh, yeah. Like, yeah. How common is this? You know, it's like we're acting like such, we're such non-locals right now.
Yeah.
Woo, okay. I feel so much better because, you know, it's one of those scenarios where you're like, no one else is really panicking. There's a few people, like, hustling and getting on the road, but it's like, you don't want to be, like, naive to the fact that you could die. So the alert that we got on our phone before everybody says, why did you panic? I'm gonna tell you why I panicked. The National Weather Service has issued a tsunami warning. A series of powerful waves and strong currents may impact coasts near you. You are in danger, period. It says, get away from coastal waters, move to high ground or inland now.
Yeah.
Not 2 hours from now, now.
We're surrounded by the ocean.
Goodness, that's crazy. So thankful we're safe.
Was